everyone, welcome back to Crit's Corner. If you are watching my video for the first time, please do subscribe my channel and click the bell icon to notify my future videos. In this video, we are going to see about the mysteries in the Bermuda Triangle. Now, let's get into the video. The Bermuda Triangle, also known as the Devil's Triangle, is a loosely defined region in the western part of the North Atlantic Ocean, where a number of aircrafts and ships are said to have disappeared under mysterious circumstances. Most reputable resources dismiss the idea that there is any mystery. This area is named after connecting the places Florida, Bermuda and Puerto Rico, which gives the shape of triangle. The earliest suggestions of unusual disappearance in the Bermuda area appeared in September 17, 1950. Article published in the Miami Herald by Edward Van Winkle Jones. 2 years later, Fate magazine published Sea Mystery Under Our Back Door, a short article by George Sand covering the loss of several planes and ships, including the loss of Flight 19. Flight 19, a group of 5 U.S. Navy crewmen, TBM Avenger torpedo bombers, on a training mission. George Sand's article was the first to lay out now familiar triangular area where the losses took place, as well as the first to suggest a supernatural element to the Flight 19 incident. Flight 19 alone would be covered again in April 1962 issue of American Legion magazine. In it, author Alan W. Eckert wrote that the flight leader had been heard saying, "We are entering white water. Nothing seems right. We don't know where we are, and the water is green, no white." He also wrote that officials at the Navy Board of Inquiry stated that the planes flew off to the Mars. In February 1964, Vincent Gaddis wrote an article called The Deadly Bermuda Triangle in the pulp magazine Argosy, saying Flight 19 and other disappearances were a part of a pattern of strange events in the region. The next year, Gaddis expanded his article into a book, Invisible Horizons. Other writers elaborated on Gaddis' ideas. John Valen Spencer, Limbo of the Lost, 1969, Charles Bellitt's The Bermuda Triangle, 1974, Richard Winner, The Devil's Triangle, 1974, and many others also keeping to some of the same supernatural elements outlined by Eckert. Hypothetical explanation attempts. Persons accepting the Bermuda Triangle as a real phenomenon have offered a number of explanatory approaches. Paranormal explanations. Triangle writers have used a number of supernatural concepts to explain the events. One explanation pins the blame on leftover technology from the mythical lost continent of Atlantis. Sometimes connected to the Atlantis story is the submerged rock formation known as the Bimini Road of the Bimini Island in the Bahamas, which is in the triangle by some definitions. Followers of the purported psychic Edgar Cayce take his prediction that the evidence of Atlantis would be found in 1968 as referring to the discovery of the Bimini Road. Believers describe the formation of a road, wall or other structure, but the Bimini Road is of natural origin. Natural explanations. Compass variation. Compass problems are one of the cited phrases in many triangle incidents. While some have theorized that unusual local magnetic anomalies may exist in the area, such anomalies have not been found. Compasses have natural magnetic variations in relation to the magnetic poles, a fact which navigators have known for centuries. Magnetic north and geographic south are exactly the same, only for a small number of places. For example, as of 2000, in the United States, only those places on line running from Wisconsin to the Gulf of Mexico. But the public may not be as informed and think there is something mysterious about a compass changing across an area as large as the triangle, which it naturally will. Gulf Stream. The Gulf Stream is a major surface current primarily driven by the thermohaline circulation that originates in the Gulf of Mexico and then flows through the Straits of Florida into the North Atlantic. In essence, it is a river within an ocean, and like a river, it can and does carry floating objects. It has maximum surface velocity of about 2 meters per second as a small plane making a water landing or a boat having engine trouble can be carried away from its reported position by the current. Human error. One of the most cited explanations in official inquiries as to the loss of any aircraft or vessel is human error. Human stubbornness may have caused businessman Harvey Conover to lose his sailing yacht, Revonook, as he sailed into the teeth of a storm south of Florida on January 1, 1958. Methane hydrates. An explanation for some of the disappearance has focused on the presence of large fields of methane hydrates, which is a form of natural gas on the continental shelves. Laboratory experiments carried out in Australia have proven that bubbles can indeed sink a scale model ship by decreasing the density of water. Any leakage consequently rising to the surface would be rapidly dispersed by the Gulf Stream. It has been hypothesized that periodic methane eruptions, sometimes called mud volcanoes, may produce regions of frothy water that are no longer capable of providing adequate buoyancy for ships. In this case, such an area forming around a ship would cause it to sink very rapidly without warning. That's all for today's video. Comment your suggestion in the comment section and also leave a comment for what video you are expecting. Meet you again. Bye.